Getting a new dog is always an exciting time, but it's really important to do your research, as different breeds have different characteristics and therefore different needs. They're also vulnerable to certain medical conditions. The Border Collie is a pastoral breed, and this group of dogs were originally bred to help herd sheep and cattle, as well as help move livestock to market. As such, this breed has a very strong natural instinct to herd. The Border Collie is very intelligent, as well as having lots of energy, and therefore they'll need lots of mental and physical stimulation. And they also love to let off steam, so this makes them ideal for active households. They generally enjoy the company of other dogs as well as cats, as long as they're introduced to each other from an early stage. Border Collie's coats generally come as black and white, as well as red merle and tricolour. There are two types of coat, smooth and rough. Border Collies do shed a lot though, and therefore they'll need to be groomed at least once a week in order to keep that coat glossy and in good order. Border Collies are very energetic, and therefore they'll need at least 2 hours of exercise every single day. Put it like this, the more exercise they get, the happier they'll be. As an intelligent breed, they'll need lots of mental stimulation, and they really benefit from positive reinforcement training. But remember, as a working breed, if they don't get this physical and mental stimulation, they'll turn that energy and intelligence into mischief. As they love to chase as well as herd other animals, it's very important that they're well trained before you feel confident of letting them off the lead in the countryside. Border Collies generally live between 12 and 14 years old. But like all breeds, they're susceptible to various medical conditions. And perhaps the most common in the Border Collie would be canine epilepsy, which is a form of fitting or seizuring, as well as diabetes. As athletic breeds, Border Collies are also prone to a condition known as hip dysplasia. And this occurs when the joints that form the hip joint don't form perfectly. And this makes them slightly more vulnerable to early onset arthritis.